With me in the studio to discuss this development is political public affairs analyst, I beg your pardon, Lulu Elegbe. Thank you for joining us. There are those who are saying, I mean, we must acknowledge that people are alluding to the fact that the confirmation of some high-profile cases confirms that it is a disease for the elite. Can you speak to that?
Well, I think that's misinformed. It's just misguided. These are the ones, so there are 46 in Nigeria. So in terms of the elite or high-profile people, I think there may be three or four of them. The others are not. So I think people need to be careful what they're putting out there about what this disease is. There are about 20,000 deaths around the world. Again, if you look at the number of people that have died from this, the number of those 20,000 people, there are not a lot of elite among them. If you look at the almost 500,000 people that have been infected, they are, again, majority are not the elite. So we need to be careful how we put this information out there, because once these things take root, it's very easy for people to start to believe that this is actually true and they're not taking it as seriously as they should take it.
Right. On the flip side, there are those who are saying this also dispels the position by some that still do not believe the coronavirus is real. They say it's a hoax, that some of this high-profile confirmation will dispel their doubts and compel them to follow some of the guidelines that have been given.
I agree with that. But I think the government needs to do a lot more in terms of campaigns and awareness, especially because many people don't believe that. You'd be shocked at the actual number of people that don't believe this thing exists. For whatever reason, they think it's a hoax. Why they think it's a hoax, I don't know. But whether the reason why they think that is not as important as the fact that we need to dispel that very, very quickly, because if people think it's not a hoax, they're not going to take it seriously. If they don't take it seriously, they're not going to take these common sense steps to prevent the spread. Because all these steps, there's things like wash your hands, social distancing, and all these other things, it's not really, it's apart from the person, himself or herself, it's also to prevent them spreading it to other people as well, which obviously would lead to an outbreak, which we don't want. So if people are not taking it seriously because they don't believe it even exists, then we have a serious problem, because they are not going to take the steps, and then we're going to have an outbreak on our hands.
We already have an outbreak. We have over 46 people.
When I say outbreak, I mean compared to
what
other
is in
countries.
Other part. Yeah. Okay, but we have 46 cases. There are those who are saying because of the lack of adequate testing, because other countries where you have high figures, they've had more number of tests carried out.
Absolutely.
There's this skepticism that the number is below what is actually the figure of those that already have the infection. What do you say to that?
Yeah, so far I think there have been 153 or 154 tests done in Nigeria, and with 46 cases. Now the problem is, that's about a third of it. But the problem is, what we're doing in Nigeria right now is what the UK was doing initially, which was not testing anyone unless they're showing symptoms, which is fine, except that, or which would be fine, except that people who don't show symptoms, so asymptomatic people, can still spread the virus. So that strategy needs to be revised, because if you're only testing people that are showing symptoms, what about the people not showing symptoms but are carrying the virus and so they're actually spreading it? So if they're spreading it and you're saying that you only have 46 confirmed cases because those 46 are part of the 153 that you've tested, or you've not tested another God knows how many because they are not showing symptoms but they are carrying it, then that's a much bigger problem, I think.
What would be your word of advice to Nigerians at this time, especially those who have some skepticism or those that are still not observing some of the rules that have been put out?
I think this is serious, this is real, this is here. We need to be very careful. The government, yes, has its role to play, but I think we have an even bigger role to play by just applying simple common sense, to be honest.
Thank you very much for coming on the news.
Thank you.